Fox Sports.
We are Fox Sports. We are San Diego.
The Padres back home at Petco to host the Giants and Madison Bumgarner as first place San Francisco looks for six wins in a row. The Padres' Melvin Upton returns from a productive road trip, three home runs in seven games. And Buster Posey loves hitting at Petco. He leads the first-place Giants into this key three-game series. And good evening, everyone. With Mark Grant, Dick Enberg, pleased that you've joined us on this Tuesday. What a run of games, division games, three with the Giants, three with the Dodgers here at Petco, and then three more back in San Francisco. It's going to be key to the early season for San Diego.
It's going to be the key for the San Diego Padres to get early leads and the pitching staff to continue what they've been doing. I could not have been prouder, Dick, of the way the pitching staff pitched last road trip on the 4-3 trip. They really did a yeoman's job.
Well, the hitters have not held up their end. They're batting only .232, but look at the pitching, especially the starters.
ERA. This is against the Giants, against the Cubs, the Blue Jays, all throughout Major League Baseball in the month of May. And quality starts, bridging that gap to Fernando Rodney's closing it out. You know, the last 16 games have been decided with three runs or fewer. The Padres have won nine of those. Why? Because they've been pitching lights out and they've been going to the arrow of Fernando Rodney.
And don't forget, in that road trip, three losses, all were by one run. They have to go against one of the talented left-handers in all of baseball tonight.
Hey, it's going to be a challenge for the San Diego Padres against Madison Bumgarner, but these Giant hitters also, it's going to be a challenge if Colin Ray has got that cutter and that curveball working. Hey, home is where the heart is. Bumgarner likes pitching in AT&T. Colin Ray tonight, he's got an ERA just a little bit over three here at Petco Park. Hopefully it bodes well for the right-hander tonight.
You know, Andy Green was leafing through the dictionary of good words, and he came up with day off, or day, yeah. Two words. Yeah. So that's really a good word. But the Padres and the coaching staff and the manager needed yesterday. Let's see if they're refreshed and they rebuild. They're going to need it against the first-place Giants. It'll be Julie Alexandria talking with Manager Green when we return.
One of your choices are probably Jay and Jankowski. It's a tough row for Jankowski to host, so we kind of give it to Will and give him the opportunity to lead off today and then put Jankowski down the nine.
Baseball brought to you by GMC, by Petco, your complete pet store, by SeaWorld. Enter tonight's keyword baseball on the Ways to Win page at FoxSportsSanDiego.com, and by Infinity. Visit your local San Diego area Infinity retailer for a test drive today.
Well, noticeably absent from tonight's lineup is John Jay. And after making a diving catch in Milwaukee on Friday, he hurt his shoulder and was experiencing some shoulder tightness. So Andy Green gave him the last two games of the Milwaukee series off. Then we had the off day yesterday and then decided to give him the off day again today. In his place, Will Myers batting leadoff. Here's what Andy Green had to say about it before the game.
Just at that position right now where we got to make some changes. More than anything, without John Jay in the lineup today, his shoulder's still a little bit on the sore side, so he wasn't available today. So trying to figure out who bats leadoff against Bumgarner when your choices are probably Jay and Jankowski. It's a tough row for Jankowski to host, so we kind of give it to Will and give him the opportunity to lead off today and then put Jankowski down the nine.
Coming up tonight, the NL West test begins. Padres and Giants underway in just a moment from Petco.
Opportunity comes in the next 12 games, each game against an NL West foe. Can San Diego climb up the division ladder? An early season critical stretch begins tonight. Giants, Padres coming up. Right now, reasonable parity reigns inside the division as just 4.5 games separate last place from first. For the Padres, rich opportunity comes in the next 12 games, each game against an NL West foe. Can San Diego climb up the division ladder? An early season critical stretch begins tonight. Giants, Padres coming up. I just love the way that sounds. Giants and Padres, you know we're going to have three outstanding games here at Petco to open this homestand. As Colin Ray and the Padres take the field. They are currently 4.5 behind the Red Hot Giants in their longest winning streak, 5 in a row. And here is the lineup for Bruce Bochy, brought to you by Hyundai. Denard Span acquired as a free agent with Washington the last 3 years, leads it off. Then it's Panic and Duffy, Buster Posey in the cleanup spot. Brandon Belt with that big long-term multi-million dollar contract at first base. Right fielder, the popular Hunter Pence, hit 6. Then Brandon Crawford
pretty good sock in that number seven spot from Crawford. Madison Bumgarner, the pitcher, hits eighth, and Angel Pagan ninth. So both pitchers hit in the eighth slot tonight.
And on the hill for the Padres, young right-hander, 25-year-old Colin Ray, making his eighth start. The scouting report is brought to you by Anderson Plumbing, Heating, and Air. He's got fastball command. It's gotten a lot better. His two-seamer is legit. I mean, it's working that outside part of the plate nicely, and the changeup has gotten a lot better for Colin Ray.
And he's enjoyed pitching here at home. His record this year, 2-0. Opposing hitters batting only .243 against his offerings. It's his eighth start of the season. And his first as a major leaguer against the San Francisco Giants. Set to go. Center fielder Denard Span settles in on a 64-degree moody May night. Cloud cover. Well, the typical May-June weather here along the coast. And the first pitch of the game is in there for a called strike. Bruce Bochy in his 10th year, 10 already, as the manager of the Giants. 773 wins and three World Series titles with that black and orange San Francisco uniform.
And it's when you play these Giants looking to win their sixth in a row.
Span takes 1-1. The umpiring crew features the crew chief Dale Scott behind the plate. Bob Davidson, Lance Barrett, and John Tumpane occupy the bases. No shift on Span. Outfield plays him to hit to left, and he takes inside 2-1.
Well, Professor, I got to say, it's nice having you back,
yeah,
my friend.
It is good to be back. You know, this is our second home back here, and you too. You had a week off. Be back in the booth with our pals.
Glad to see you.
Yeah, good to be back, and we'll share some of our experiences in Israel when we have a moment or two. Incredible trip. 2-1 falls low, 3-1. Now, Span will take a lot of pitches, and he's walked 20 times. He's the ideal leadoff man, hitting .272, throwing 20 walks, and he sets the table for Panic, Duffy, and Posey down the line. And he walks to lead off the ball game. Well, the Padres defense is brought to you by your San Diego County Ford dealers. Matt Kemp is in right with Jankowski in center. Upton over in left field. Around the horn on the infield, Rosales and Ramirez on the left side. Perella and Myers at second and first, with Norris behind the plate for Colin Ray. Will Myers in the lineup. That's the good news tonight after being scratched a couple of games in Milwaukee. First with a lower leg problem and then with the forearm. Joe Panic, former St. John's University star in New York, now just 25 years of age, broke in last year, a major league season. He hit .312.
Didn't seem to be phased, did he? One bit. Came up, contributed, was a integral cog in that lineup for the San Francisco Giants.
Well, Panic and the man who follows, Matt Duffy, they fit into that category of homegrown, bring them up, and they both produce right away. And of course, the Padres, that's what they're building their farm system toward, that same kind of activity and production. Interesting situation with Span at first, infield at double play depth. Padres lead the National League with 42 twin killings. And the Giants lead in hitting into the most double plays. Actually, the Padres have 46 double plays, and the Giants have hit into 42.
See the left side of the infield bunched up towards the second base bag. And of course, Will Myers holding on the runner. So bunching up towards second base with the hope of a ground ball that way.
1-2. Slap foul. So tonight, tomorrow night, Thursday night against these Giants, then Friday, Saturday, Sunday, a big weekend series with the Dodgers, then right back on the road to AT&T Park in the Bay Area to play the Giants three more. And this is the litmus test for the Padres here in mid-May. They've got to stay close. And it's going to be tough. All the best pitchers for both the Giants, Bumgarner tonight, then it's Cueto and Samardzija, so there's no relief in terms of getting to the back end of the rotation in this series. And Kershaw is ready to go for the Dodgers on the weekend. Mercy. None of that.
Well, if they keep putting together good at bats like they did against the Cubs, against the Brewers, take your chances that way.
they are beatable. They cannot walk on water the last time I checked. So, sure, it's going to be challenging. If both clubs have their pitching like it's been going, it's going to be a pitcher's duel, as advertised, I would say.
So every run will be precious, and we know the team that scores first has an added advantage. Ray trying to keep the Giants scoreless. Ooh, that was on the corner, but not getting the call from Dale Scott. That was strike three.
And that's exactly where Colin Ray wants to be, especially the left-handers. Bury it inside. That's that two-seamer that comes back, and that's a nice frame job by Derek Norris. He got squeezed on that one.
Back with the 2-2. Center field. That chases Jankowski, still retreating and makes the catch against the wall. Hat flies off and Span returns to first. Just measured that one. The ballpark the right size for the Padres on that shot off the bat of Panic.
And thank goodness that ball was in his glove just before he hit the wall, because he had a bead on it. As we take a look at the cutter, he tries to backdoor it. Panic gets extended. Okay, now the sound of the ball at the bat. Flash look, twist, turn. Watch the ball hit the glove, and then just then,
slap in the face from that center field wall.
Nice to meet you, center field wall.
A long out brings up Matt Duffy, the third baseman, a 25-year-old former dirtbag at Long Beach State. He shot even his biggest fans with the Giants last year. He didn't hit a home run in 3 years playing with the Cal State Long Beach, and then last year hit 295 with a dozen homers. Loves that big league pitching. Up high, ball one. 93 on the fastball. Any word about Tim Lincecum? Is he going to sign with the Angels?
I think he signed a 1-year deal with the Halos.
Yeah, that's interesting. Mm-hmm. Of course, he tried out for all the major league teams, including the Padres. That's in there, 1-1. Year-old Colin Ray. He was a good selection for the Padres 5 years ago in the draft. He was still available in the 12th round out of Indiana State. Change up, breaking ball, took a little off it.
Yeah,
81 miles an hour.
That was a good one. And good location as well. Good arm speed. Look at the rotation. 12-6 on the curveball, and the front side of Duffy exposed. The hip opening up, the shoulder opening up. Takes all the power out of that swing. If in fact he does make contact, it's just a little roller to the left side.
Now Ray trying to follow up his last home start, remember, against the Mets. Mm-hmm. He went into the seventh inning. Two outs in the seventh before he gave up a hit.
Hey, pretty good move right there for the big right hander. Mm-hmm. Colin Ray. Nice short quick throw, arm slot, like throwing a dart over to first base. Check it out. Quick with the feet, quick with the upper half. Throw a dart over there from the ear. And trying to throw it on that outfield side of the first base bag to try to get that runner.
The 1-2 pitch in the dirt, blocked by Norris. How about our keys to the game, Mark Grant, brought to you by our San Diego Honda dealers.
Well, you take a look at the Giants being in town, and for the San Diego Padres, one of the keys is no crooked numbers for the Giants. They're one of the top three teams of putting crooked numbers up there in each frame. And also jump on the fastball early from Madison Bumgarner. Avoid the strikeout. So you might see these Padre hitters being aggressive on the fastball early if they get it.
You could call that challenges mm-hmm. of the game rather than keys to the game. It won't be easy against Mad Bum. Fly ball to right field. Kemp retreats, goes back, and makes the catch over the shoulder. He had trouble Sunday in Milwaukee. A couple of balls hit like that got by him. And he barely had enough leather to snare that shot.
Well, right off the bat, he turned the wrong way, and then panic kind of sets in. And at the last second, he gets extended. That's a great recovery by Matt Kemp in right field. Well, Colin Reyes, thank you very much, Matt Kemp. And applause from his teammates on the bench.
So a long out off the bat of panic and a line drive out Duffy for two away. And here's Buster Posey. Checks in at 273. Runner goes. Throw by Norris to second. He is safe. The Span has his fifth stolen base of the year, just under the tag at second.
I don't think anything else that Derek Norris could have done to try to get the runner Span. Quick release. The throw is on the right side of the bag.
Bench coach Mark McGuire checking on the video room to see whether their challenge is in order. Perella, the second baseman, making the tag on the back of Span as he slides into the base.
You know, it happened so quickly for the umpire because he sees the sweep there, right? Is it a whiff? Well, from his vantage point, it's kind of tough to tell. If he does make contact, it happens so quickly.
It looked like the back of the jersey fluttered as the tag was made, but they're not going to challenge. So Posey with a runner in scoring position. Well, the Giants have won five in a row. They've done it without taking advantage of a lot of scoring opportunities. Get this. Of late, they're hitting 125 with runners in scoring position. 56 chances, only seven RBI base hits.
Well, the Padre pitching staff has to take care of that and keep those numbers going. They've proven that over the last road trip and the month of May. We documented that.
Off the plate, 2-1 to Posey. His 318 batting average here at Petco in 40 games played is as good as anyone in the National League. Seven home runs here. And that'll level the count at 2-2.
Trying to keep the ball away. You can see from the Fox tracks, breaking balls, fastballs. Doesn't mean he won't chase up and in either. But Colin Ray has the scouting report. Every pitcher has every single scouting report on every single hitter. Gonna stick to that game plan and execute those pitches. Trying to dot that outside part of the plate.
Sharply hit but foul past third.
And that one was in just enough off the plate to where he couldn't get hurt. That ball leaks over middle in. Trouble with a capital T. And there's some magic happening right there for that little Fryer fan.
As per usual, lots of orange and black Giants fans coming down here to our great city to root for their beloved baseball team. A high chopper to the left side, loved by Rosales, and the inning comes to an end. Well, we've talked about the good pitching of late for the Padres, but good pitching is all the better when the defense supports. Jankowski at the wall takes extra bases away from Panic, and Kemp snares Duffy's bid to right field. Day in San Diego as we check the Padres lineup, brought to you by Toyota. Will Myers in the leadoff spot, a new batting order for Andy Green with Norris second, then Kemp and Upton. Alexi Ramirez elevated to the fifth slot, then Adam Rosales and Jose Perella. Colin Ray, pretty good talent with the stick. hits eighth, and Travis Jankowski, left-handed hitter against the left-hander Bumgarner, placed in the ninth spot.
And the scouting report for Madison Bumgarner, aggressive in the zone. He's got the wipeout slider, and he will elevate by design. And his scouting report is brought to you by Tough Shed.
Bumgarner, three-time All-Star, not only an outstanding pitcher, but regarded as maybe the best hitter of pitchers in baseball. In fact, he won the Silver Slugger Award each of the last 2 years. Will Myers back in the lineup, brings his 7 home runs and 17 runs batted in. He's 1-for-14 in his career against Bumgarner, and takes ball one. While Bumgarner has dominated not only the Padres but other teams, here at Petco he's only 3-4 with an ERA over 4. Maybe the Padres will come up with some magic tonight. Line drive, right center field. Span retreats and makes the play. Well, just as the Padres denied the Giants in the first inning, Span returns the favor, stealing a base hit, an extra base hit against Myers.
Hey, a couple of things here. One thing, Will Myers going with that pitch, and I don't think he could have squared that ball up any better. And you know what? Tip your cap to Denard Span. For a millisecond, Dick, it looked like he didn't have a bead on it. But then once he went back and committed himself, he reached up. I think that was the difference in that play. That's a big league play right there by Denard Span.
Boy, some great defense in the outfield already, and we're not out of the first inning. Here's Derek Norris. He has had success against Bumgarner, and not many players can pat themselves on the back, although his season average 188. He's hit in as tough a luck as any Padre, a lot of line drive outs. But against Bumgarner, in his career, hitting 346. Grounds that sharply, but right to Duffy. Couple of balls well hit, both for outs. Well, the Giants defense tonight is brought to you by Renovation Realty. And here's how they set up, with Span making his presence known already in center, with Pagan to his left and Pence to the right field area. Duffy, Crawford, Panic, and Belt around the infield. Crawford there at shortstop, a gold glove last year, and Posey behind the plate for Bumgarner.
Hey, when you talk about employing the shift, the Giants are 27th. They've only shifted 137 times this year.
Yeah, they shift here on Matt Kemp. Enters the game as the Padres' leading home run and RBI man, and pops it out of play.
The team with the fewest shifts employed, Miami Marlins, with only 40. The most in Major League Baseball. How about the Houston Astros and A.J. Hinch? 603 times they have shifted. Man. And as you mentioned, chalk up another shift employed by the Giants. Three heavy on the left side, Professor. So now it's 138 times that Bruce Bochy has shifted.
One strike to Kemp. Shallow and center. In comes Span for the easy play, and it's a 1-2-3 inning for Bumgarner. No score after one.
hard. I don't think you can question that at all. I think everybody out here goes out every night with the expectation to win a baseball game. It doesn't matter who we're playing or who's technically on the field for us. We believe we have enough out there to win a baseball game. I don't think we started the year expecting Drew Pomeranz to be like a horse at the top of the rotation, but he is, and nobody really had Cesar Vargas on the radar, but he's pitching very well in that five spot in the rotation. So I think more than anything, we're getting production from guys that probably wasn't expected, and you have to feel good about that.
Manager Andy Green speaking to the resilience and fight that this ball club showed on the road, and hopefully it will carry over into this homestand. Guys.
Thank you, Julie. Anyone who watched the Padres on that last road trip, as we had an opportunity to catch Don Orsillo and Mark Swinney and the great job they did. I mean, there's no denying it comes right through your television set. This team is playing hard for Andy
Absolutely.
Green, and he's milking every ounce of talent out of a lineup stripped by all the critical injuries and still making every game close. They win four and lose three on the road trip, and all three losses by one run.
Absolutely. And you know what? That could have very swung either way. And you talk not only the physical aspect of the ball game, but the mental part of the game that these guys have to endure trying to piece together games. And the guys in the bullpen, I mean, that was a tough road trip, and they came out smelling very nicely.
Brandon Belt having a good season. He leads the Giants with a 305 average. 3-1 the count. Line drive over the shift and into the right field corner. Kemp goes over to dig it out. Doesn't take a kind bounce for the Padres, but Belt will be satisfied with the stand-up double. The first hit of the game goes to Brandon Belt.
Well, Brandon Belt likes to milk the count. He likes to work that count. He likes to get the walk. He's third in the National League as far as walk percentage, 19% of the time. But if he gets a pitch down and in, you can see that swing path of his. It will sound good off the bat, like we just heard there, for that double.
Yeah, that's not a shift designed as yet to deny a base hit like that. Here's Hunter Pence, the right fielder, leading the Giants in home runs with a half dozen. And he's tops in RBIs as well with 29. The 29 runs batted in ranks him fifth in the National League.
And Hunter Pence, I guess he would have to fall into the category of the Will Rogers of hitters. He never saw a pitch he didn't like.
Yeah.
Right? I mean, he's going to be hacking.
Ramirez deep into the hole on the left side. No shift here, but Ramirez way over toward the third baseman, Rosales. Look at that. A ball and a strike to the 28-year-old from Texas University of Texas Arlington in his backyard. Grew up there. Now 33. A career 284 hitter. Just hit his 200th career home run in the last week. What a good player.
Mm-hmm.
And there's the base hit to right field. Hesitating was Belt, so he'll hold a third on a sharp single to right off the bat of Pence. So first and third, no one out for the Giants here in the second.
Well, that ball was hit so sharply, I think, from the vantage point of Brandon Belt at second base. He thought that maybe this ball could have been caught on the line or hit so hard that it's short hopped that maybe, just maybe, Will Myers could get the short hop and throw him out third, because from his vantage point, he can't tell that that ball's hit sharply in the hole there. It might look like it's right at the defender. So he had to hold his ground a little bit.
You have to play it defensively initially off the bat. You don't want to run yourself into a double play. Runners at the corners for Brandon Crawford, the shortstop. Four home runs this year. 29-year-old former UCLA Bruin takes low ball one. Crawford, until last year, had never hit more than 10 home runs in a major league season. Last season, he must have been eating his Wheaties for breakfast, because he came through with 21 home runs and 84 runs batted in. Think of that production from a shortstop.
Yeah.
And the gold glove with it.
Oh, yeah, one of the better shortstops you'll see in baseball. No doubt about that.
Infield back, they'll give up a run for a chance at a double play, and the count goes 2-0. Ball hit to Rosales at third. He could check the runner, but anything up the middle, they'll try to go for two.
Yeah, the ideal thing, like you mentioned, Dick, to Rosales at third base or a comebacker to Colin Ray. Try to turn two quickly. Pretty good pitch.
And just at the knees, 3-0. There's his progression in the last 3 years, counting this year. But he goes from 10 home runs, his career high, to 21 last year. And that ball is struck deep and long, way out there, and it's a 3-run home run for Crawford. Yeah, that's what we're talking about. Newfound power for the shortstop, Brandon Crawford. That's his fifth of the year, and the Giants jump in front on one swing, 3-0.
Well, he got the green light. It was 3-0. So let's go back to pitch number one, a breaking ball, trying to go soft early. And then 2-0, just misses there. Now he gets the green light from Bruce Bochy. How does he get up on top of that high pitch like that and send it on its way? That's the amazing thing to me. I could see middle in, dropping the head, but he went up and out to get that last pitch.
So the Giants strike for a big three here in the second inning. And here's Madison Bumgarner.
Look at the coverage of this pitch. Four-seamer up on contact. That's away, but yet he still enables to stay flat through the zone with the barrel of that bat, stay on it, stay on top of it just a little bit to send it on its way.
If he had taken it, that would have been ball four.
Absolutely.
It's above the letters. So number five on the season for Crawford, adding to his RBI count, now 19. 423 feet on that smash. And strike three taken by Bumgarner for the first out here in the second. That'll bring up the number nine hitter, left fielder Angel Pagan.
Hey, and you know what? Even though that pitch was up and away, he did some damage with it. With the pitcher coming up next, why not swing 3-0?
Well, you fans know I'm a big supporter of getting that early lead, even if it's a 1-0 lead early, because it tends to correlate with victory. And when you look at the Padres, they are a classic example of what happens when they score first and what happens when they don't. As we look at Pagan, when the other team has scored first this year in 24 games, the Padres have managed only 3 wins. Yet when they score first, they're 14-1.
Yeah.
So they're going to have to climb uphill tonight. Pagan lifts that one into foul territory and back into souvenir corner. Plenty of time to try to catch up, but you hate to see a talented pitcher like Bumgarner given that 3-run cushion early. Two balls and a strike.
And like any pitcher, Dick, you get a 3-run lead early, it gives the pitcher to be much more aggressive with his stuff. Madison Bumgarner, sure, we all know about him, but 3-run lead, yeah, it's gonna take some chipping away.
And Ray falls behind another hitter, 3-1.
Well, I know each umpire has their own strike zone, but right now it seems early on that Dale Scott not giving that two-seamer to the inside part of the plate against lefties. Something we'll have to keep an eye on.
Could have been called a strike. Yep. Right on the corner. And ball four. Second walk from Ray, and that'll take the Giants to the top of the order in Denard Span. Tonight's game is presented by Sony, the leader of 4K Ultra HD. Darren Balsley, the pitching coach, out to try to settle down the 25-year-old right-hander.
Words of encouragement. Darren Balsley very rarely, as the sun sets to the west, very rarely will throw mechanical issues into the head of a pitcher when he's out there on the hill. It's just too much to think about. He's trying to concentrate throwing good quality strikes. The last thing he needs, hey, keep your shoulder tucked. Hey, your stride's a little bit too long. Hey, stay on top of the baseball.
Too much data.
Yeah, exactly.
Too much info. Let me just pitch here. Don't make me think. That can really hurt a team, you know, pitchers that think. Span walked and stole his fifth base the first time up. And he takes ball one.
And we take a look at the ratio during the course of a ball game and a heavy workload early. 44 pitches and not good. 23-21 for Colin Ray.
That's a strike. Joe Panic on deck. Taco Tuesday at Petco Park, huh? Did you get your tacos?
I did in the dining room. You bet.
I think he went for seconds. Swing and a miss. Throw by Norris, and Span has another steal. Or rather, Pagan with a steal. And that places another Giant in scoring position.
Well, take a look at the leg kick from Colin Ray. It looks like a traditional high leg kick. A lot of pitchers will go that route because they want to throw a good quality pitch. Sometimes if they're too quick with the leg kick, it messes it up. They miss over the zone, spells trouble. So he's choosing to go with the traditional leg kick from the stretch with the runner on first base that time.
Third base pilfered by Angel Pagan this year. A ball, two strikes. Back over the mound. Nice use of that 6-foot-5-inch frame as Ray able to climb the ladder and take a possible base hit away from Denard Span. Holding at second base was Pagan.
Hey, folks at home, watching that play, that's not an easy play. You got a pitcher throwing full effort towards home plate. Okay, now the chopper. Now he's got to retreat. Now he's on a hill. He's got a grade behind him. He catches it. Step, step, find some flat ground, and then throw the rock over to first base for the out.
He's got some hops, and no wonder he was an all-district basketball player back in Cascade, Iowa.
Boxing him out and getting the rebound.
Yeah.
Very athletic move.
Yeah, well done. So two outs to Panic, who sent Jankowski to the wall in center field to grab his deep drive in the first inning. Skips that one in, 2-0. As thus far in the first two innings, it's not the Colin Ray that we saw against the Mets flirting with the no-hitter into the seventh inning. He's been off target. Fifth pitch already, and he's not out of the second inning. He only has five outs on 49 pitches. Three and oh. Matt Duffy on deck. Crawford picked on a 3-0 pitch to hammer his three run shot and the 3-0 lead.
Hey, 3-0. Thank you. I was going to say, got to be careful. 3-0. Just don't lay it in there with that runner on second base. Joe Panic just might be hacking.
Lifted to left, play for Upton, waits for it to come out of the night, and the inning is over. But Brandon Crawford, a three-run home run, and the Giants lead by three. It's a 3-0 lead going to work in the bottom of the second inning.
When we talk about rocket arms, Madison Bumgarner, you know, the velocity's been down a little bit, but he'll touch around 92 or 93, and the opponent's only hitting 241. And look, you see the lefties, you know, they like to get extended. Hey, righties up and away, 333. So the bottom line is up and away, and then it looks like lefties down and away, or righties down and in.
Quicken Loans rocket arms bringing you that information. Melvin Upton batting cleanup tonight. The left fielder off a terrific road trip. In the seven games, three home runs. And in May, Melvin batting a lusty 348 this month. Upton, Ramirez, Rosales, the 4-5-6 hitters in the Andy Green lineup tonight.
Dick, that graphic we just showed about Madison Bumgarner and the rocket arms, that was combined averages throughout the strike zone. It was righties and lefties combined. So, you know, there are certain ways to break that down because, you know, he pitches quite well against left-handers. I mean, he's eating up left-handers alive. So that was a combined strike zone with the statistics that you saw, the averages.
In fact, against left-handed pitching or left-handed hitting, this lefty, left-handed hitters batting 139 this year against Bumgarner.
Anemic.
Talk about hitting your weight, huh?
I wish.
Strike three. That's his first punch out. Upton caught looking. Now the tools of the trade brought to you by Rams Trucks.
And we're going to focus on Madison Bumgarner. What are the tools in his toolbox? Well, we know about the fastball. 92-93, pinpoint control down and away to the righties. And then just when you're looking for the fastball, how about the slider? He throws across his body. That's why he's eating up lefties. And then don't forget the old number two. You get the body way out in front. A lot of swing and misses at the foot of the back right foot of right-handed hitters with that curveball.
Here's Alexei Ramirez, one of the puzzling aspects of this shortstop, the veteran shortstop, 34, Cuba, is he hasn't hit a home run yet this year as a Padre. That's certainly contrary to his record with the White Sox in 8 years in Chicago. He averaged over 13 and a half home runs a year.
Well, they come in bunches.
Oh, there you go.
So hopefully it starts tonight or within this homestand.
That'll be a souvenir back at home plate.
I'd like to see Alexei get comfortable in that home run trot pretty quickly.
As we watch Alexei, we think about Alexei Amarista, who is starting a rehab assignment. He's in El Paso tonight. And a swing and a miss at a ball in the dirt. That's back-to-back strikeouts for Bumgarner.
You know, we focused on the fastball, the slider, and the curveball. Well, remember, he throws a cutter. He also throws a changeup once in a while. But that working around the baseball looked like a slider. And here's the breakdown. Fastball cutter in on the hands of the righties, the curveball, and then coming in fourth place is the changeup, which is thrown very rarely.
Just enough to keep you honest.
Yeah.
So two outs to Andy Rosales. The third baseman checks in at 178. A couple of home runs. Going to be celebrating his birthday on Friday when the Dodgers are here. Andy will turn 33. Pound in the strike zone.
You know, Bumgarner's got the big wingspan. He throws across his body. He comes from that first base side. You know, his foot is on the third base side of the rubber, but his front foot lands on the first base side of that rubber.
Strikes out the side. Upton, Ramirez, and Rosales. And we go to the third. Giants lead 3-0.
top of the third. Now, do not adjust your TV sets, people, because I would like to introduce you to this furry friend. No, this is not the subject of Photoshop. This is real. This is Giants third baseman Matt Duffy's cat, Skeeter, weighing in at a very impressive 27 pounds. Now, that's down from 30 to 35 pounds approximately that apparently he weighed during the offseason, but entered this season, as Matt says, in the best shape of his life. He became an internet sensation and is now the subject of his very own Instagram account. You can follow him at DuffCat35. That account is run by Matt's sister, and the cat resides in Long Beach with Matt Duffy's parents. And just to put it in perspective, other things that weigh 30 pounds, 60 water bottles, a microwave, a child's bike, and a toddler.
My goodness. And its name, if you want to get personal, Julie, is Skeeter.
Mm-hmm.
It looks more like 220-some-9 pounds. Maybe it's just the angle. I mean, that's a bunch of fur right there.
That's not a feline. That's a Fee-99. That's a fat cat. Yeah. I love fatties, though. Love nothing like a big old fat cat just to cuddle up against.
Ground ball left side. Duffy right to his counterpart, Rosales, for the first down.
Yeah. Cat not happy about the 5-3.
That's a plump pussy right there. You better have some food ready for that Skeeter to eat if you go and call Kitty, right?
Oh.
Buster Posey grounded to third his first time. You're just joining us. The Giants got three runs on one swing. Shortstop Brandon Crawford clubbing a 423-foot drive to deep right center field in the second inning after Belt and Pence were aboard on a double and a single. They give the Giants an early 3-0 advantage. And there's a high fly ball to left. Didn't get it all. End of the bat. Upton there. Two away.
Once again, taking the sting out of Buster Posey's bat, pitching him very well. You could hear that one all the way up here. Off the end of the bat. Not that solid sound.
Brandon Belt found the sweet spot with his swing. A line double rifled into the right field corner to lead off the second. Then Pence shot a single to right field, first and third, to set the table for Crawford's three-run homer. And a line drive, another base hit. That's a soft liner that drops into right center. Belt is 2-for-2. Now the leading hitter for the Giants coming in with a 305 average. That'll boost it a few points higher.
And Dick, when you're swinging the bat extremely well, that once again, that was all not on the sweet spot. Let's check out this curveball right here. And does it get it off the end of the bat? Down by the label, it looks like. Because it really didn't have that solid sound, but yet falls in for a base hit. Brandon Belt swinging the bat extremely well.
That sends Hunter Pence to the plate. He singled sharply to right and scored on Crawford's home run in the second. A career 284 hitter, Hunter Pence, and he's hitting 287 this year. Again, Ramirez, the shortstop, trying to take that 5.5 hole away from Pence. Way into the hole. Pence went the other way with a single. In the dirt. Good stop by Norris.
Well, Colin Ray is throwing confidence in that curveball. No doubt about that. He'll throw it any time. You know, once you get the feel of that, throw it first pitch strike. You can bury it then and trust your catcher to smother it for you for the strikeout.
Two outs, Belt at first. Check swing, roller, foul.
Well, you know you're getting old when you look at that happy birthday column of right. celebrities. Sugar Ray Leonard is 60 years
Come
old
on.
Today. 60.
He was just boxing yeah. in the Olympics as a kid.
Isn't that amazing?
That is amazing.
That old clock just keeps spinning around and another day is gone.
Yeah.
Another year. 1-2 to Pence.
You know, it's amazing, Dick, as the Padres, hopefully let's focus on this homestand, but, you know, after the next road trip, we're already into June.
Well, tomorrow will mark the one-quarter mark of the season.
It's unbelievable.
Be the 41st game. About the middle of the game tomorrow yeah. will be the half of one-quarter mark. 2 furlongs.
Yeah. I love it when you make the horse racing references. Horses for courses, right?
You bet. That's why I picked Derek Norris today, and he hit the ball hard, but again, yeah. right to a glove. Out of play. That's an upper deck souvenir.
Do we have another Triple Crown winner, possibly?
Well, yeah, Nyquist is much the best, huh? 8 straight victories for that 3-year-old.
Yeah.
Headed for the Preakness in a week from Saturday.
How about that if there'd be back-to-back years? Yeah.
Well,
Triple Crown winners.
It happened before, didn't it? Wouldn't the Seattle Slew and, I don't know, testing my, you know, Secretary of Seattle Slew and somebody else was in there, too. But
we can get on that.
Yeah, let's look that up.
We have the technology.
Really?
We can look that up.
Do we have to call the Preakness, call Baltimore tonight? The last time horses won back-to-back Triple Crowns.
How about a punch out right here, down and away?
Chop right back to Ray. He'll take all of those that they want to hit to him. Giants lead 1, middle of the 3rd, 3-0 for the visitors. For a great moment in All-Star history, brought to you by Geico. 2007 All-Star Game, San Francisco, National League leads 1-0. Fifth inning, Ichiro drills the first pitch off Chris Young of the Padres deep to the wall and right, takes a crazy bounce back toward right field. Ichiro keeps right on a going all the way around and inside the park home run. The American League would hold on for a 5-4 victory, and Ichiro would be named the game's MVP. Bottom third of the Padre order here in the third, Perella, pitcher Ray, and then Jankowski against Madison Bumgarner. Perella with a Padres first hit down the left field line and into the corner. Perella cruises into second, will take a turn and break right there as left fielder Pagan gets it in. The Padres had the leadoff man on, a double for Jose Perella.
Hey, being aggressive early in the count, and Bumgarner looks like that's a cutter down and in, right into the swing path of Perella. And you betcha. You know how long that barrel of the bat stays in that zone, and once again, it doesn't have to be off the sweet spot, out in front of it. but not enough to go foul. Very nice for Jose Perella.
And he gallops into second with a double. Colin Ray now 1 for 14, trying to move the runner along, and he won't get the job done. Posey jumps like a jack in the box out of his crouch and snares it in front of home plate and denies the sacrifice.
Well, you ain't kidding, Dick. Buster Posey, as soon as that ball was bunted, he's all over. He's going to let the umpire make the call. Hey, if it's foul, it's foul. Make the play.
2-4 on the put out.
Here it is. Now remember, it's where Buster Posey touches the ball out in front of home plate. According to Dale Scott, it is in fact a fair ball. And he makes the 2-3, 2-4. Check that, 2-4 put out.
So unable to help himself, Ray. Now it's Jankowski with one out, and then Will Myers, the leadoff man. Unfinished business. Yes, there were back-to-back Triple Crown winners that involved Seattle SLU in 1977, and then the next year affirmed in 1978, won the Triple Crown. Dan Smith, our old buddy over at Del Mar, knows everything about thoroughbred racing, helping out our Connor Larson with that information.
Nicely done.
Jankowski, 28 at bat, 7 hits, 250 average. Trying to pick up the Padres' first run off Bumgarner. Chip away at that 3-0 lead.
Yeah, one thing I like to look at is when pitchers are pitching, especially runners in scoring position or third base, wild pitches. Madison Bumgarner has no wild pitches this year. Not that really big breaking ball that would work into it being a wild pitch, right? He's got the cutter, the slider that he very rarely bounces. He doesn't have that big looping curveball that could bounce in the dirt once in a while.
Slap foul.
Hey, you know what? I like this, that Travis Jankowski, you know, we hope John Jay gets better, no doubt about it. Integral part of the Padres team, no doubt about that. But you know what, though? This is Travis Jankowski playing in the big leagues against one of the best, and yeah. I like it. Hey, kid, here's the test. This is what, you know, if you're going to be successful in the big leagues, you got to face the best like this. And here's what it's going to sound like and feel like, lefty on lefty.
Knocks that one just foul. About 3 feet foul, or that's a run for the Padres, Julie Alexandria.
That's right. Well, Travis Jankowski saw hitting it in the 9-hole today. He sees it as sort of a second leadoff hitter. And of course, with John Jay out of the lineup, Andy Green wanted someone in front of Will Myers to kind of set the table for some RBI opportunities. And Jankowski says he plans to make the most of all of these opportunities to start here. He said he's found his rhythm. He feels more comfortable at the plate with getting more at-bats.
Well, he's only 4 years away from his university days at Stony Brook. He's 24, learning on the job. He's already getting A grades on defense. Outside, 2-2.
And the majority of the pitches away to Jankowski, pitch number 3 kind of leaked in, so he can look that way. And look at the way the defense is playing. Playing him to go that way in left field down the line.
Pagan guarding the line there in left field. Big hole in right center. A line drive, left field, right at Pagan. Now, normally that's a two-base hit right down the line, but Pagan shaded well over toward the foul line, able to make the play on the lineup.
Pitcher,
so two away.
Pitcher hitting his spot. Ball put in play. Defensive player right there to squeeze it for the out.
So it's up to Will Myers, who lined out to the center fielder, Denard Spann, who raced back toward the warning path in center field to leap and take an extra base hit away from Myers. Two out, Perella with his lead at second. Ripped, just foul again. That's two shots. One by Jankowski, and now Myers just wide of the field of play.
He's spinning on it. And foul.
Well, he's had some good swings against Bumgarner tonight in his two at bats.
Just a little bit too far out front.
lays off the high fastball. And the Giants have their top three pitchers lined up for the series. Tomorrow night we're going to see Johnny Cueto 5-1 against the Padres' Drew Pomeranz, who has been outstanding. ERA at 1.80. What a matchup. That misses away 2-1. And then Jeff Samardzija on Thursday night. Reminder, Thursday night an hour earlier, that's a 6:10 game. And Samardzija, the former Notre Dame wide receiver, maybe the best athlete on this Giants roster, against James Shields. So good pitching matchups in games 2 and 3.
He and Matt Cain exchanging some notes, eating some sunflower seeds, enjoying the big league ball game.
And that ball low, 3-1. Derek Norris on deck. Takes a strike.
That's a good pitch, 3-1. That was the four seam fastball at 92. And once again, the velocity starting to go up a little bit more for Baumgartner. He himself said, you know, the mechanics kind of out of whack a little bit, kind of working around the baseball.
Swing and a miss, strike three. And so the leadoff double by Perella wasted. And we go to the fourth inning with the Giants in front, 3-0. A little how do you do there around home plate. What's this all about? And Baumgartner, he's never been one to back off from a confrontation. And Bruce Bochy wisely says, I'm going to get my ace out of here. And now all the way from the center field bullpens, here come the Padres and the Giants to join the scrum.
You know, Dick, I'll be honest with you. After that strikeout, I was marking it down on my scorebook, anticipating going to break, and all of a sudden, the Jerry Springer show breaks out around home plate. I don't know what was said. Here it is. Swing and a miss.
What's he, Baumgartner, taunting Myers? Yeah, come on, says Myers. And so Baumgartner did. He came on. Engaged in verbal warfare with Myers over what we do not know. Nothing serious. And we'll see when Bumgarner comes up to the plate. He'll hit second in this inning if Colin Ray will speak to him. It'll be Crawford, Bumgarner, and Pagan for the Giants in the fourth. Crawford with the big blow in the game tonight. Three-run homer is fifth of the year for the 3-0 Giants lead. As Mark Swinney joins us, Mark Grant, Mark Swinney doubling up here, giving all their insight as the Padres and Giants are in game one of the pregame series.
Welcome back, Professor.
Thank you. It's great to be back.
Welcome back for you, too.
Thank you, Mark Swinney. What did you gather from that little rhubarb?
That was pretty interesting. There's all kinds of emotion in the game, and Madison Bumgarner is known for that. I think that's the reason why he has an edge to him that you have to have, as you know, Mark, as a number one guy. But it was pretty interesting, and a lot of jawing. I think it had a lot to do with Bumgarner. You could see him voicing something to Will Myers. I love the emotion of the game, guys. Listen, this is what it's all about. You're competing for 9-plus innings.
I'm wondering, and once again, I'm trying to evaluate the whole situation. But remember the 3-1 pitch that he buried in, and then Will said something to the umpire. And we saw Will's reaction. It was kind of like, hey, is that it as far in or is that on the inside corner? Whatever the question was to the umpire. He said, yeah, and he agreed with the umpire. No harm, no foul. Now, I don't know whether it was something because he was asking the umpire about something. You know, how dare you ask the umpire if that was a strike or not?
Roll to the right side, and Perella takes care of Crawford for the first out here in the fourth.
I don't know, but here we go. Here's a strikeout, and then Will. I couldn't tell you what he said right there, but he did mouth something to him.
So the fans greet the announcement of Bumgarner as the next hitter. Well, we're mid-May, and the wear and tear of a long season. Don't forget, they've been playing this game seriously since way back in late February in spring training. And this is what happens. The season progresses. The tempers are shorter. And it's not necessarily meant to be a friendly game.
Well, Dick, we saw the tempers flare Sunday in Texas against Toronto. It is. It's the part of the year that you start emotionally invested in games. And when you have these rivalries, you never know what moment is really going to start that.
1-2 now to Bumgarner.
So much going on in that Texas-Toronto series as well, dating back to last year.
Yeah, the bat flip, how you handled all of that. But
you know what I didn't like about that is the fact I thought the Rangers didn't distinguish themselves at all in the manner in which they went after the Blue Jays hitter. They waited until the third game in his last at bat before they hit him. If they wanted to hit him, go ahead and hit him in the first game and let the retaliation, if there's going to be any, at least give the other guys a chance. I thought that was a low blow.
I understand your point. You got to remember, too, Bautista was hitting 167 and has been struggling for a period of time. I agree with you where there's a certain way that you can do it. And listen, we don't ever condone hurting somebody for a reason. But he, after he gets hit, he slides in hard to Rougned Odor. And the fight's on. How about this?
That's a well-landed right hand.
Wow.
And he stayed up on his feet. He's got a good jaw. Bautista. And that pitch misses.
That reminds me of Mark Grant when he started popping off to me. I decided to just drop.
No way. I'm a lover, not a fighter.
Well, and so is Sweeney. Did you see the hug fest here?
Oh,
he and Don Orsillo? My goodness.
There's a lot of hugs going on in Milwaukee.
A lot of love. Right three call. Fans love that. Second strikeout for Ray. And it's time now for greater coverage of baseball, brought to you by T-Mobile. Suspensions today handed down from the commissioner's office. Odor gets 8 games for punching Bautista. Bautista, 1 game for the aggressive slide, and John Gibbons, the manager of the Blue Jays, for re-entering the field after he'd been thrown out arguing a pitch earlier in the game, gets 3 games off.
Heard something pretty interesting today, and Gibbons not only got kicked out of that game before the fight on Sunday, but went up to Toronto and got kicked out for arguing balls and strikes the next day. You think about that. That's not a good decision.
The pot's boiling here in mid-May. Pagan walked his first time.
You know, I thought there was going to be a stiffer suspension for Odor. I thought it was going to go maybe 10, 12 games.
I agree. You know, especially for the everyday players, they're going to get more games. And it's games off. It's not days off, right, which I think is pretty important.
See, that's why when pitchers get suspended, I think it should be by the start.
Yeah, I agree.
It should be two starts. Not, you know, 5 days. Okay, you get to pitch one game, then you're off the next four or five anyway.
Yeah, I agree with that, too.
So all of that brings us to the baseball fighters, those that seem to have some boxing prowess. And in your day, Mark Sweeney, if you could pick one guy you knew, either a teammate or someone else, to say, okay, you want to put up your dukes? Okay, here's my man. Here's the guy that I'll take my chances with in a fight.
Man, when you're on seven different teams, you got to really think hard.
You know who
about
I got?
That?
Jim Gott.
That's probably Jim Gott.
Jim Gott, right-handed. He knew that Tai Chi stuff. I mean, he could put his fingers through a concrete wall just like butter. He could rip out your thorax.
Oh, come on.
No, I'm serious. Jim Gott was one tough guy.
Yeah.
John Denny.
Drive to right field. That chases Kemp back, and he makes the play. Pagan lines to right. Three up, three down. The Giants' story in the fourth.
Padres baseball brought to you by Sequan Casino. Sign up for the new Padres club card today. By Jack in the Box. Taste the bacon-licious sourdough bacon ranch combo. And by your San Diego County Lexus dealers. Bottom of the fourth inning here at Petco Park. The Giants with a 3-0 lead on Crawford's three-run home run. It'll be Derek Norris, Matt Kemp, and Melvin Upton against Madison Bumgarner in the home half of the fourth.
Some good defense, Mark Sweeney.
Yeah, especially the first inning. You saw the center fielders really make impactful plays.
How about Travis Jankowski going straight Fabio?
You know, I thought you just made a good point, too. It's good to see Travis Jankowski get this opportunity today, especially against Bumgarner, but also see his defensive prowess, which has been very good.
Derek Norris takes strike one. He grounded sharply to third his first time. Well, he's kept his wits about him despite the fact he's hit in so much tough luck all season long. 0-2.
You know, that was the disappointing part when he got hit on the hand the other night. Coming off a really good game, and then he ends up getting hit off the hand.
And then he comes back and hits a big home run.
It was huge.
When watching on television, I thought, that could be a couple of months. That really hit him flush, didn't it? And a swing and a miss. That's five strikeouts now for Bumgarner.
When we talk about the breaking ball, this looks like a hard slider, maybe? Curveball? Kind of wrapped it a little bit more, huh? once again, Bumgarner with that curveball. It's not the big looping curveball. It's more of a sweeper.
Matt Kemp fly to center his first time. Lifetime against the Giants. Kemp has hit well. 285 and 19 home runs against Giants pitching. And 63 extra base hits. That's more than any active player against Giant pitching. Against the NL West, made some hay, 338, put it in the barn. But against the teams outside the Padres division, not so successful.
Well, you look at the Padres and what they are faced and the challenges against Madison Bumgarner. I really believe the right-handers especially have to look out over the plate. If he's getting that called strike inside, it makes it very difficult because it just cuts in on your hands. He also has that curveball that we've seen that neutralizes that thought process.
Swing and a miss, one and two. There's the curveball.
Yeah, you know what I'd like to see one time? Some manager out there just load up lefties if you got them against Madison Bumgarner. Because it takes all the pitches away. Everything would be going away to the lefties. The cutter, the curveball, the slider. Hey, just a thought. Is anybody going to do it? Highly unlikely. But why not try it once or twice just to see what happens? Take your chances. Take the middle part of the plate away from the lefties and just think outer half and see how he can be effective.
Yeah, I think a lot of people don't realize when you're talking about a cutter and everyone thinks of Mariano Rivera when you think of cutter, it's the opposite way. It's the same side. Right-handed hitters have better success against a Mariano Rivera. That's the reason why, to your theory.
To the third baseman on two hops, Duffy throws him out. And Kemp gone for the second out here in the fourth.
But to your theory on that, Mark, that's exactly what I would try to do. Yes, he's had success against left-handers. But you have to have the ability, and it's a lot easier to extend your hands rather than adjust your swing on a cutting action ball.
Remember Bruce Bochy pinch hit against Mariano Rivera in the World Series? Andy Sheets. And everybody's like, how could you do that? It's a righty on a righty. Well, he was taking away the cutter from Mariano Rivera.
Here's Upton, took a third strike, his initial at bat. Loops that one just over the Padre dugout. Julie, you have a chance for a play there. Got to charge those.
Well, if you look at the cutter and against right-handers, you see it just boring in on those hands. Very difficult to stay inside. Your adjustment visually, it's coming in on you, but you've already thrown your hands at like it's a middle pitch, and then you have to try to adjust.
Yeah.
Jams a lot of hitters.
Yeah, that's a tough pitch to keep fair, too, isn't it, Mark? If you
very
get the
tough.
Head.
Up high with a 91 mile an hour fastball. Bumgarner, only 26. I mean, he's still reaching the prime of a great career. He's looking for his 90th win already this year in this game, 90th in his career.
Well, you'd think you'd have a tail off, especially with those extra innings and playoffs that last few years, you say the five seasons, the extra innings that he's throwing. And he's just a horse. You look at those legs and what he can do to establish that consistency. That's the reason why you marvel at that.
Yeah, that expression in the clubhouse, we're going to go with the big horse today. That's the big number one man. Well, he fits that description in talent and in body size. He's 6'5 and 250.
Yeah.
Count stays at 2-2. Alexei Ramirez on deck. And a full count. Bumgarner doesn't walk many, and he's gone to a full count. That in itself is somewhat rare. Five strikeouts, no walks. The only hit, Perella, double, leading off the third. Strike three called. That's a half a dozen
In the strikeout column for Madison Bumgarner, it's still the Giants 3, the Padres nothing.
That are ahead of you in the standings, like it's a great chance to make up ground. And we know how good these guys are. We know what arms we're facing. We faced them in San Francisco not too long ago. So we drew kind of the heart of their rotation once again. And these guys here and then the Dodgers coming in right after them, it's a good opportunity for us to kind of make up some ground. But I think more than anything, it's just an opportunity today to beat Madison Bumgarner.
Yeah, it's a bad luck of the draw for Andy Green and the Padres getting the top three pitchers for the Giants. And then they get Kershaw and Maeda, the top two of the Dodgers on the weekend. Think about it. The Giants swept the Padres in San Francisco. If that had been reversed, let's just say, and the Padres had won the three, they'd be only a game and a half out of first place. I mean, that's how tight things are currently in the NL West. But you got to beat the big boys, yeah. And here's the chance for San Diego in this series.
Well, a lot of parity in this division, but you also understand, too, Dick, and Mark knows this, it's a challenge every night in the big leagues, and it just seems like that's your thing, and you have to take advantage of pitchers that aren't pitching well at times, but you're going to get this pitching, especially in this division.
Denard Span, the leadoff man, will start things in the Giants' fifth. He's walked and tapped to the mound.
We see it all the time in this game of baseball. You'll come across a team that has a starter that's got a 6.5 ERA. Mm-hmm. Next thing you know, he's in the eighth inning.
Yep.
Sometimes you face one of the better top three guys in the league with a 1.5 ERA. Next thing you know, he's out in second.
Pulled foul by Span. Panic and Duffy to follow here in the Giant fifth. To see who threw out the first ceremonial pitch tonight, Andre Reed. I had a chance to call many of his games, wide receiver with the Buffalo Bills. Finished his career with 951 catches and 87 touchdowns.
Wow. It's a great career.
Those are possibly Hall of Fame credentials for Andre Reed. And here he is. Let's see what kind of form number 83 lives
good,
here
huh?
in San Diego area.
Good shape as always.
Rocks and fires. Man, a little off speed, and Cashner couldn't come up with
he's
a bounce.
He's got to pick that. Come on, Cash.
Yeah, well, he's got to block it. It was an 0-2 pitch, right?
Swing and a miss. Strike three. Third strikeout for Colin Ray.
Mark Sweeney, what do you got there?
Yeah, he got a backdoor cutter,
nice.
Which is really nice. See on our Phantom cam, that cutter comes back in the barrel underneath the baseball.
I love the that pitch because hitters sometimes will give up on it and then hits it outside corner. Well, he offered at it, swing and a miss for the strikeout.
Well, Mark, you talked about the scouting reports earlier in the game and how much is involved with these guys, and the two seamer has been very successful for Colin Ray in previous starts. So why that backdoor cutter to lefties, it's just a different look.
Panic, high fly foul. He sent Jankowski crashing into the center field wall. Jankowski making a fine catch in the first. And panic fly to left field as last time. Right center field, and that's up the alley. Can Kemp get there? Yes, he can! The veteran Kemp runs that one down and takes extra bases away from Panic. Talk about hitting in tough luck tonight. Panic robbed of a couple of extra base hits.
Well, you can see Travis Jankowski doing a good job of backing up, but Matt Kemp, it looks like he had a bead on that one the whole way. That first step, so important. Hey, let's face it, Matt Kemp doesn't have blazing speed, so that's why that first step is so important, and that's another big out for Colin Ray.
And sends Matt Duffy to the plate. He's lined to right and grounded to third. Take strike one. Well, the Giants come here to Petco after a very successful four-game sweep in Arizona at the start of this road trip. Fly ball slicing down the right field line. That'll be out of play. Three runs, four hits for the Giants, but they put three hits back to back in the second inning, a double by Belt, a single Pence, and then the three run shot off the bat of Brandon Crawford.
This is Colin Ray's third 0-2 count.
Fly ball to right, could be a play for Kemp as he crosses the foul line for the final out. So that's seven in a row, retired by Colin Ray. One, 4.5 in the book. Giants lead 3-0. Time now for the San Diego fans of the game. Having a good time here at Petco Park.
Seat dancing. I was a seat dancer, a champion in eighth grade.
Were you really?
Yeah.
What was your prize?
Yeah.
Fly ball lifted to right. And Ramirez is gone. One pitch, one out for Bumgarner, who's allowed only one base runner, a leadoff double Perella in the third inning.
And people laughed at me for picking Jose Perella to pick the stick tonight.
Who laughed at you?
Oh, yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
I can't think. No, let's say I didn't laugh at you. Did you laugh at him?
I didn't laugh.
Was that only the Julie? She didn't laugh.
Pomeranz doesn't pay attention, so he didn't laugh.
No, he was laughing at his own joke.
Yeah.
He's over there in the corner.
Exactly.
You're hilarious. Andy Rosales.
takes strike one. He struck out swinging the first time. Bullpen busy. Carlos Villanueva tuning up. A ball and a strike. So Chicago was rainy. Milwaukee was a little chilly, huh?
Little chilly. And thank you for the roof at Miller Park. It was very important.
Mm-hmm.
Very cold.
Adam Rosales takes strike two, one and two. All his friends call him Andy, but Adam up there swinging the bat. Swing and a miss, strike three. Number seven for Bumgarner. Some of the Padres a bit overmatched against the talented left-handed tosses of Adam Bumgarner.
Well, at times, Madison Bumgarner will go up by design. That was one of my bullet points on the scouting report, and that right there is proof in the pudding.
Brings up your pick in the pick the stick, Jose Perella. He only hit a double to left, but you said that was going to be a home run. That's right. Only halfway there, right?
Still plenty of baseball left.
All he needs is another double.
There you go. We'll count that as a home run. That's a four-pointer.
We just got to find that guy that laughed at Mark.
I think we've got our research team kind of running with a fungal bat. They're kind of working their way through the brushes and bushes here. Well, no one's laughing at you. You're the runaway leader.
Yeah.
My goodness.
It's not how you start. It's how you finish.
Well,
you
true.
Know that. Yeah. I don't get overly excited. But I'm happy with where I'm at, obviously.
Are you going to reveal your formula as we progress here in the season?
Well,
ground ball deep at short. Long throw Crawford. He makes everything look easy. Another 1-2-3 inning Bumgarner. We've completed five. 3-0 Giants. Here's our Harris game summary. Brandon Crawford, one swing equals three runs, a long 423-foot clout right center field. Back in the second inning, brought Belt and Pence in before him, and Madison Bumgarner working with that big early lead, not only using his arm but his mouth, on his way to a one-hit shutout through five innings. No harm done there as he and Myers with a long-range communication that got a little warmer as the both bullpens empty. As Carlos Villanueva comes in, it's our El Cajon Ford pitching change.
Well, Carlos Villanueva was one of those guys, Mark Sweeney, on this road trip to try to bridge that gap and eat up some innings, because I tell you what, this team needed a blow, and the guys really did a nice job of giving Andy Green some innings. Had the day off yesterday, so he's ready to go. Hold the Giants at three runs.
So Ray goes five innings, three earned runs, four hits, walk two, struck out three.
Middle of the order, Posey, Belt, and Pence for the Giants here in the top of the sixth. Drive to right center field. Kemp can't get there. Just over his outreach backhanded try. And it's Posey into second base with a double. Villanueva greeted by the Giants catcher, a two base hit.
Four seamer up and away. And you know what? That's just typical Buster Posey when he's swinging the bat well. I did talk to some of the Giants people before the game, and that they said Buster Posey was a little bit cold. Got a couple hits in Arizona, but when he starts swinging like that, that's when you have to be concerned.
His ninth double of the season. He leads the Giants. Here's Belt, a double and a single tonight. Brett Wallace enters the game, a double switch with Villanueva coming in to relieve Ray. Wallace goes to third. Rosales from third to second base, and Perella to the bench. Generous call there. One and one.
The changeup from Villanueva. Well, Carlos Villanueva has to do it with location, and you take a look at his delivery. He goes from the extreme first base side, pretty basic, straight up on top, high three quarter. And like a hitter, Mark Sweeney, you talk about that front leg being stiff, it generates all the power, same principle for a pitcher as well. See the stiff front leg?
Well,
that gives him power up the grid, and bam, out in front.
What makes Villanueva very difficult from a hitter standpoint, given different looks, and also adds and subtracts on all of his pitches. So that is the threat if you're in the batter's box.
Yeah, he's not going to blow hitters away. He's touching 88, 89. Flipping stuff up there with movement. Working in and out, as you can see. Southland Technology Fox Tracks.
Check swing and a foul ball. Belt unable to get out of the way of that one. It would have been ball four.
Shaka, man. Hang loose.
Good night for sunglasses.
Yeah.
The lights are bright.
Whew. New lights. There they are.
Scarves, love them. Underrated.
Really?
Oh, big fan.
You needed that in your last road trip to Chicago and Milwaukee. You'd look rather dapper, I think, with a nice scarf. A little ascot and a scarf to go with it.
And when you wear that scarf, you got to follow the Padres Baseball Live with the MLB.com at-bat app.
Hey, nice segue.
Stay up to the moment at any moment with game day, live game day, video highlights, statcast, news, and more. Download MLB.com at-bat, the number one app for live baseball on your phone and, how you doing, tablet.
With a scarf.
Yeah, well, Mud, when we brought up scarf, he thought he meant eating. He was going to scarf up some chow.
You can do that, too. Yeah. Especially on a Taco Tuesday.
I love Taco Tuesday.
Dollar tacos on Tuesday nights at Petco. We've got college night coming up Thursday night. You college guys and gals, $10. You buy your tickets in advance. And then on Friday night, instead of beer fest, we got cocktail fest.
Oh, hey now.
5 o'clock. And then Saturday, fireworks, hopefully against the Dodgers. And then more pyrotechnics after the game. 3-2 to Brandon Belt.
Hey, he might go off speed right here.
Good protective swing. Fouled off a good pitch right on the edge. Got to swing at that one.
Well, with the runner on second base, a series of signs from Derek Norris. And universally, it's first sign after two. I'm not saying that's the case here, but
let's see. One.
Focus on two. Okay, no two, so flip a coin.
Take a pick.
Might be first sign after one.
Let's see. Fastball away.
I'm saying change up away. Mark Sweeney.
3-2, strike three on a fastball. First strikeout, Villanueva.
Well, off of that curveball, he goes to the fastball. 3-2 curveball was fouled off, dotting that outside corner with the fastball.
Dale Scott winds up and punches him out.
And judging by that, Mark Sweeney had the off-speed pitch in the back of his mind, because Brandon Belt very rarely look at a fastball. go by him like that.
Hunter Pence, single and a comebacker, one for two. Dodgers and Angels are in a freeway series. The Angels won last night. Swing, a wild swing and a miss. 0-2. That's the Hunter Pence that you're going to see every time you come out to the ball yard. Dodgers currently leading 3-1 over the Angels in the sixth inning. Colorado beat St. Louis tonight in St. Louis. 3-1. Hey, the Rockies are 20-18.
Well, Walt Weiss has them playing consistent baseball, and good for him. It's been a challenge up there to even get their pitchers to throw strikes. They know they have the lineup in Colorado, but pitching is always the bugaboo when it comes down to it.
Yeah, some of the pundits feel that the Rockies have the best lineup in the National League West.
Yeah, it's pretty potent. They can play some D as well on that infield.
Arizona leading the Yankees again tonight, 5-1 in the seventh. They beat the Yankees last night. They pounded them. We're going to see the Yankees. I believe they open the July schedule for a three-game series here in Petco. A lot of those tickets already sold. People in advance getting their location ready for the Bronx Bombers. Throws his bat at it, a looper to right, and it falls for a hit. Holding at third, Posey.
That's a really good play by Matt Kemp. Watch it. This is already going to be down, and he knows it, but he positions his body behind the baseball to play the longer hop rather than the shorter hop, getting in better throwing position. He throws a strike all the way into the plate, holding Posey at third.
Well, there's Pence just flipping the bat out, protecting the outside corner, and punches a single to right field. First and third for Brandon Crawford. This is the same situation that Crawford looked at in the second inning, men at first and third. No score at the time, and he belted that long home run. Takes ball one. Low. 423-foot home run for Crawford. He grounded the second his last time.
Well, these home runs that Crawford is hitting, and you touched on earlier in the game, Dick, he's looking to power the baseball now, especially with that year he had last year.
And he hits this one deep to right field. Kemp is there, however, tagging his Posey, and he can stroll home. It's 4-0. Crawford with his fourth RBI on the sack fly to right.
Well, the home run was up and away. He got extended, that two seamer over the heart of the plate. Off the end of the bat, didn't have that clean, crisp sound off the sweet spot. And it really slows it down there. You can see the vibration of that bat there staying off the sweet spot and hitting it deep enough for the sack fly.
Posey scoring. Crawford has knocked in all four runs tonight. And here's Madison Bumgarner, greeted by the jeers and boos by Padre fans after a verbal altercation with Will Myers earlier. And he delivers a base hit to center field. His third hit of the year. The Silver Slugger Award winner the last 2 years in the National League as the best hitting pitcher.
This is going to be interesting. The conversation possibly over at first base, if any.
The base hit moves Pence to second. Two outs. The number nine hitter, Angel Pagan. So three hits given up by Villanueva here in the sixth inning. Came into the game with opposing batters hitting 329 on the season. Hey, there are looks that ball players, athletes have. Angel Pagan has that look. If I were a Hollywood producer and I said, I want a guy just to look mean and nasty, I mean, he's a great guy and a good person, good. But look at that look, huh?
Yeah.
Hey, you want me to take care of George for you?
deck.
The car running and the mall is driving. I wish I could look mean. You know, yeah. I try in the mirror to look mean. I just can't pull it off.
Rips it. One hop. Oh. Myers, good hands. That saved a run. Pagan denied, but the Giants add on 4-0.
Where emotions definitely got the best of both sides. And Will Myers trying to get ready for his at-bat. This is the previous pitch before he gets called out. And, I mean, swings through the pitch. And he calls timeout. Massa Bumgarner puts his head down, and he gets frustrated. Well, the next pitch goes, and he strikes out. I think Will Myers is frustrated himself. Massa Bumgarner has some choice words, and then the feud starts, but I think that was the reason why, if you look back at that at bat, and why Madison Bumgarner was upset at that. No reason, in my opinion.
He's also an inning ago didn't leave the field. He went over to Dale Scott, the plate umpire, and they must have chatted for 30-40 seconds. And it's almost as if Madison Bumgarner feels that every pitch is a strike,
yeah.
You know, that everything should be his way. And we've seen that not only tonight, but in past performances. And hey, there's nothing wrong with that. To think that you're the best and everything's going to be your way. But you don't see that very often.
Yeah.
You go over and have a long conversation with the plate umpire.
Yeah, and you know what? That was after the inning. Remember Jose Perella? He called time a couple times.
Ground ball, Brett Wallace's first at bat, and it squirts right through. Brandon Belt and Joe Panic, both men diving for the ball. You couldn't have measured that one any better as Wallace has the Padres' second hit of the night.
Well, we've seen against Brett Wallace all of the defensive shifts, especially on the right side. The Giants don't do that, especially against the left-hander Bumgarner. And he capitalizes in between. And I thought Panic thought Brandon Belt was going to make that play. Awkward dive by Panic.
That was a classic miniature golf shot right there. Through the windmill, through the clown's mouth, all the way to the green.
Bad doggone clown's mouth. That
yeah.
Got me every time.
Got me every time.
You got to time it perfectly. He timed it just perfectly on that base knock.
In fact, I got so upset once I had to, you know, go for a new ball. I mean, went through the clown's mouth.
Make
right
me a balloon, clown.
So you want the green one instead of the blue ball?
Yeah, right into the golf shop. So the Padres now with two hits off Bumgarner and had a high pop foul off third out of play. Duffy can't get that one as Will Myers. Go check that. Travis Jankowski fouls that away. Kind of confuses the old scorebook when you have that pitcher hitting in the eighth spot in the order.
Let's see if Travis brings in that bunting game here. Try to take it with him. Brandon Belt is up with Wallace on first base.
Jankowski takes strike two, 1-2. Line to left field, just missed an extra base hit, lining down the left field line, and then with Pagan, almost with his foot on the foul line, was able to catch his line drive the last time. Two and two. Yeah, with no one out, opposing batters at 292. But with one out, tougher, and with two outs, good luck. Strike three.
Wow.
Big swinging curveball, and Dale Scott saw that one. Strike three.
Well, I'll tell you what, yeah, we know Madison Bumgarner is good, but he doesn't need help like that. I mean, it's tough enough as it is, and the numbers prove that. He's tough enough to hit as it is already. And now he's getting this.
Wow.
Now you can see Travis Jankowski not agreeing with that.
So one out, top of the order, Will Myers.
You know, that's what frustrates you guys, going back to that conversation that Madison Bumgarner has with home plate umpire Dale Scott, and then getting calls like that.
Strike one to Myers, who has lined the center. A good catch running away from home plate by Denard Spann. And he struck out the last time. Mm. 0-2. Yeah, Padre fans would love nothing more than to see Myers tag one.
I'd love to see it too.
But he's in the hole two strikes.
First two pitches away. Let's see if he tries to bury one down to that back foot.
Well, raises the eye level with a fastball. Myers wouldn't bite.
Let's peek into Buster Posey here, see what he's got going. Fastball in.
And too far inside, 2-2.
I think he's going the curveball.
All right. Let's see if you're on target here. That could have been called strike three. Fastball, 3-2. Four nothing Giants. Padres with the leadoff man Brett Wallace on with a single, one out. And the payoff pitch. Well, this rooftop shot brought to you by Pinnacle on the Park. Pinnacle on the Park. Three balls, two strikes on the leadoff hitter, Will Myers. 70th pitch from Bumgarner is lined for a base hit to left center field. That's got some carry. It's going to go all the way to the wall. Wallace is around second to third, and they will hold him there. A double for Will Myers. A little poetic justice there as Myers answering Bumgarner with his bat.
Well, he battled the whole at bat to get to 3-2, which I thought was so important in our fan-up cam. Watch the balance of his swing. Head down on the baseball and drilling this. Very little vibration, drilling it into left center gap. Gotta love that approach by Will Myers.
That with one out, the Padres with a couple of men in scoring position. Get right back into this game.
I'll tell you what, Brett Wallace, he hit the wall right about there. And Glenn Hoffman puts up the stop sign with one out. Hey, I know Madison Bumgarner is tough to hit, but you gotta take that chance. He would have been out from here to El Cajon if he would have sent him.
Ooh, good cut by Derek Norris, who has grounded out sharply to third and struck out.
Plus, with one out, Mark Sweeney, right? You got to give him that chance two times to try to get him in, right?
Exactly.
Infield back for the Giants. They'll trade a run for an out.
First trouble spot for Bumgarner on the night. There again, Norris backs out of the batter's box. Bumgarner didn't like that when Meyer stepped out, and now he's going to visit with catcher Posey.
Well, they're going to have a conversation, and what you go to if you're Madison Bumgarner is over-reliable, like to pitch in. But Derek Norris has had good career numbers against Madison Bumgarner.
346 in previous meetings, 9 hits and 26 tries, including a home run. Tidy little pitch count for Bumgarner, only 71 tosses. One out in the sixth. Two. And after a pitch out of the strike zone. Yeah, you got to protect home plate. Just trying to make contact. Try to punch one through. A ground ball up the middle, you get a run at least. High.
The last two pitches he tried to elevate a little bit and overthrow a little bit. Hey, all it takes is one pitch to overthrow, and you leak it over the heart of the plate. Hey, it happens to the best of them.
In the dirt. 2-2.
A good layoff there by Derek. That's tough to lay off, I would say.
And when you lay off those pitches, you gain confidence. Working that count even. You see the curveball. Job by Posey, but a better job by Norris.
Crawford comes in from shortstop. He talks with Bumgarner, and he's in a social mood tonight. Mad Bum, he wants to talk now to Posey again. With a runner at second base, Myers, they want to make sure no mistake made on the communication on the call for pitch by Posey, so they verbally probably have said, okay, what do you want? Here's the pitch. 2-2. Derek Norris. Slow curveball, and Norris goes down swinging. 9 punch outs now for Madison Bumgarner, so the Padres won't be able to score a run on and out. It's up to Matt Kemp.
Sometimes he'll take a little off that curveball, and that's exactly what that was. Well off the plate, trying to make Derek Norris fish for it, and that's exactly what happened.
He obviously wasn't expecting that slow curveball. He was off balance from the start of the swing. So Kemp, fly to center, grounded to third. Padres need a 2-out base hit here. A couple of men aboard. Wallace at third. Myers at second. Fastball.
That 91 looks harder, doesn't it, Mark?
Yeah. And the reason why, he hides it. It's deception when it comes down to it.
Throws across his body.
We say it all the time about Ryan Buchter, why he's having success. He hides the baseball. For Madison Bumgarner, it's the delivery.
Popped up foul territory. A long run for Belt. And makes the catch going away. Now the Padres squander their best chance. Lead runners at second and third. And Bumgarner has shut them out through six. Giants 4, San Diego nothing. Padres Baseball, brought to you by Mercury Insurance. We're on a mission to save you money. Log on to mercuryinsurance.com today. By Jerome's Furniture, proud sponsor of the best seats in the house. And by San Diego's Best Window Company, simply great windows. Top of the seventh, Villanueva second inning of work in relief of Colin Ray. Top of the order, Span, Panic, and Duffy. Span 0 for 2, walked in the first inning and stole his fifth base. And takes it low, ball two. So tomorrow night, 6:30 here on Fox Sports San Diego for Padres Live, the pregame show with Mike and Mark. Fouled away, Cueto 5-1 with a sparkling 2.97 ERA for the Giants against Drew Pomeranz of the Padres, 4-3. And you talk about ERAs, how about Pomeranz?
Yeah.
With a 1.73 batting average against and an ERA of 1.80. That's in there, 2-2.
Drew Pomeranz having an all-star season up to this point.
Yeah, I would say if you had
absolutely
to vote.
He and Fernando tonight. Rodney, right? If you were picking two.
Yeah, and I think Pomeranz, because of his eight games, all outstanding. Yep. And the count goes to 3-2. Villanueva all around the strike zone. Out of play. And it's time now for the Bill Howe plays of the game. Good goal to the first inning. How about Jankowski racing all the way to the wall? The wall comes up to greet him. And Jankowski making an outstanding catch. That denied Panic an extra base hit. And then Matt Kemp on the next batter goes back and able to reach up and snare the bid by Matt Duffy for extra bases. Our Bill Howe plays of the game. 3-2. High fly ball, right field. That's hit well. Kemp back to the wall and makes the catch. A long out off the bat of Denard Span, who has only one home run all year.
Got under it just a little bit too much, and Matt Kemp eyeing the wall, warning track, getting back there quickly so he can square up, back up against the wall, and still with a little room to spare up against the turtle.
And a tough turtle, mind you. And tough luck for Span. Villanueva able to breathe now. He was holding his breath on that bid by Span. Here's Panic. 0 for 3, and a couple of potential hits taken away by one Jankowski. You just saw that play in the first inning, and then Kemp made a good play into the right center field alley the last time. Another 2-0 count. Two and one. And Mark, we had a chance with the weekend off on Saturday morning to go over to Mission Bay and be part of the celebration of a life-size statue for our buddy Bill Walton.
I saw that.
It was terrific. Yeah, the turnout, the mayor was there. And Bill, who loves to ride his bike, and the sculptor used his bicycle as a platform, and then of course Bill with that 8-foot wingspan in that triumphant pose of his. Yeah. I'm the luckiest guy in the world.
I saw that tweeted out. A nice picture of you and Bill.
And I love Bill Walton. We go all the way back to his days at UCLA. And his contribution to our community, I mean, he could well be the ambassador to San Diego. He's involved in like 70 different charitable organizations giving back.
You know, it doesn't surprise me because that guy lights up a room when he walks in. Doesn't he? He just brings so much energy to a room. Just a great personality and Always gracious with his time.
Yeah, we got to get him back up in the booth. When he starts calling baseball and gets on the umpires.
I could take an inning off. I would love to have
so
Bill.
So can
back
I. If we get him started.
Ground ball pulled to Myers, and he'll get the job done himself. Two away. Yeah, Bruce Walton, his brother, who was an outstanding athlete as well and played offensive line for the Dallas Cowboys, he introduced Bill, and he said, you know, I'm always wary when I introduce Bill to give a speech. He's going to say a few words, and his first sentence often lasts 10 minutes. he's a great guy.
Sure is.
And his wife, Lori, what a team they are. Two away to Matt Duffy. Strike with a breaking ball.
Another breaking ball. You see what Villanueva is trying to do here, down and away, and the infield shifting that way. On the ground, outfield playing to go the other way.
Two strikes on Duffy. Giants leading 4-0 here in the top of the seventh. As they go for their sixth win in a row, this is their best winning streak of the season. Well, this is a special day for one of our buddies here, a great pitcher up there in Point Loma. The Boomer, David Wells.
Yeah.
He threw his perfecto on this date. Ground ball bobbled as Ramirez unable to come up with a play. Tough chance. And safe at first is Matt Duffy. See how the official score rules it.
You know, I got to be honest with you. Alexi Ramirez makes that play 99 out of 100 times. It's an easy grounder. 1, 2, 3, 4. And you know what? If I'm giving him an error on that one.
And so is the official score. Good. Rare error for Ramirez, who is really solidified
absolutely
the defensive infield with his play at short.
And I'll bet you, Dick, if you ask Alexi, should he have, he would be the first one to say, yes, absolutely, I should have had that play. Should have made that play.
So the inning stays alive, and that means Buster Posey gets another swing, a double in three trips, scored his last time. Yeah, David Wells against the Twins on this date, 1998, with a perfect game. He may be watching tonight and with good memories of one of his outstanding performances. Fouled off the head of the bat. And it's another day, 1984 on this date, May 17th. Remember Alan Wiggins, five stolen bases in one game.
Oh, that's some thievery right there.
Put you behind bars, you steal that one.
Pilfering.
Tied the National League record.
Yeah.
There goes the runner, the throw through, and out. At second base is Matt Duffy on a perfect throw from Derek Norris. That'll do it. Top of the seventh inning for the Giants. A strike by the catcher Norris. Padres coming up, stretch half of the seventh. They need four to tie.
beginning of work, but what's been working for him tonight? We know about the cut fastball, but the location of the righties down and away outside corner. Well, how about the curveball? Just when you have one pitch, he drops the curveball on you, and then don't forget about old number one. Even though he missed with location, that one he wanted in, he got away with it up and away. Madison Bumgarner striking out 9 tonight. Going straight Bob Seger. 9 tonight.
There you go. Melvin Upton Jr. to start the Padres' seventh inning. They have 3 hits off Bumgarner. Had a chance in the last inning after the single by Brett Wallace, a double Will Myers with 2 outs, but Norris and Kemp couldn't get the run home. Upton has struck out both times looking. Oh, shattered bat. Easy one hopper to the mound. One away. That'll bring up Alexei Ramirez. He has struck out and flied to right.
Well, I love the Phantom Cam, and this will slow it down. Watch on contact. Watch this wood.
Wow. Some kindling.
Yep.
That's 10 in a row retired by, well, check that. Bumgarner did have a run of 9 in a row before the single by Wallace in the last inning. Ramirez 0 for 2. So economically, as per usual for Bumgarner, with no walks, only 81 pitches to get into the seventh inning with one out.
Oh yeah, he's good for about 110, 115 as well.
I mean, he's a horse.
Yep, he is.
We'll see another horse on the weekend, a different weight category. Clayton Kershaw deep at third. Duffy high throw right over Belt's head and safe at first base on the air. Alexei Ramirez. Duffy launching that high toss, and even Belt with his best leap couldn't come up with it.
Yeah, I think Matt Duffy had more time than he realized and worked underneath this one. An accurate throw is going to get Ramirez. And you know, you'll talk to a lot of first basemen, and the first thing out of their mouths will be, hey, I can only jump so high. I'd rather have you bounce it.
Yeah.
I'll pick it for you.
That's why I've got that big piece
That's
of leather
right.
on my hand.
Yep.
So Andy Rosales comes up. He has struck out both at bats. See if the Padres can take advantage of the miscue. Christian Bethencourt is in the on deck circle. The pitcher's spot is due next. 2-0 to Rosales. Padres need base runners. Foul back. As we take time for the In the Driver's Seat, brought to you by Kia. In the driver's seat is Madison Bumgarner. He's got his hands wrapped around the steering wheel, doesn't he? Only 3 hits allowed, no runs, 9 strikeouts, and not a single walk.
Yeah, he's definitely in cruise control tonight.
Foul back, 2-2.
Tyron Guerrero up in the pen.
Just called up on the weekend. Joined the club in Milwaukee from El Paso. He's a big old drink of water, 6 feet 8 inches, a right-handed pitcher. Another strikeout. Rosales has gone down all 3 times. 10 strikeouts for Bumgarner.
Well, it looked like the curveball from Bumgarner. Let's check it out of the hand. Yep, curveball it is. And Adam Rosales way out in front of it. Nice block by Posey. Number 10, double digits tonight for the left-hander.
Bethencourt, who hit a monster home run at Wrigley Field, Chicago on the last road trip. His third of the season. There's his numbers on the year, 237, only 38 at bats and 9 hits. A third of them home runs. And he hits this one well to left center field, but not long enough. Pagan there to squeeze the final out. And the Padres are gone in the seventh. The Giants still lead it 4-0.
Giants lead right now, top of the eighth inning. Look forward to seeing you on Padres Live, the post-game show, which will be brought to you by Cox Communications. But before we turn it back over to Dick Enberg and Mark Grant, I want to show you what happened. And tonight, the Toronto Raptors were taking on the Cleveland Cavaliers, Eastern Conference Championship ball game. Take a look, LeBron James and company, and Mike Breen and Jeff Van Gundy have the call. Listen in.
Dick Enberg would have said, oh my. I mean, that's really, what a handle that guy has.
When you say that, say the great Dick Enberg.
That is a great Dick, legendary.
All right, that's even better.
Probably should have said Hall of Famer, but that's just my opinion. Let's get you back up to the legendary Dick Enberg and his sidekick. Mark Grant.
Hey, you're looking pretty dapper. I like the sweater look there, Mike.
Thank Bomber. You, buddy. I was, you know, I figured I'd honor your return with a professorial look.
Yeah, very nice. Yeah, that is professorial. Well, Jeff Van Gundy and Mike Breen, they read it just the way I wrote it.
Yeah.
I mean,
that's great. Getting some recognition there. Yeah, worldwide there,
yeah,
professor.
I like a little love. Yeah, that was very nice.
Guerrero, as you mentioned, Dick, all 6'8 of them. I mean, a lot of kneecaps, a lot of elbows coming right at you. And I like the number he's wearing.
Oh, yeah, that's your old 55, huh?
Anxious to see this kid throw.
You know, back at Mike Breen, I have to smile every time I mention his name. By the way, a product of Fordham University.
Yeah.
Vince Scully. That when I was a young announcer leaving college and working for Fable WSAM in Saginaw, Michigan, as Buster Posey leads it off here in the top of the eighth inning against Guerrero. Posey, a double and scored the fourth run, and he hits this high in the air, piercing the night. Finally coming down, says Matt Kemp, for the first down. And my boss, his name is Bruce Small. He said, you know, he called me in his office, and I'm just 21 years old at the time. He said, do you ever think about changing your last name? I said, what? He said, yeah, Enberg. He said, you know, changing your name, maybe something that's a little more flowing. He said, I changed mine. I said, gee, I didn't even think of that. So I did. I thought, well, what would I change my name to if I did?
Right.
Thank God I didn't. You know, you had heard of your entire family. It's not a common name, though you might think so. You won't even find an Enberg in the entire Manhattan phone book if they still publish those things. And I came up with a last name, Breen. I was going to be Dick Breen.
Really?
Because my middle name's Allen, and Dick Allen, you know, there's already a Mel Allen.
Right.
So I just thought Dick Breen really sounded, you know, refreshing. And
I think you did the right choice.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, I wasn't going to change, but it was a nice exercise to think through. Like,
Well, you think about it. How would you change your name to Mark what?
I wouldn't.
Lederkrantz?
I wouldn't even know where to start.
No.
You know what? Because it's a name you carry with you from your mom and dad. And
Presidential?
Yeah.
Belt pulls one foul. He has a double and a single, a strikeout tonight, adding to his club leading average, now batting at 313 on the year. Well, there it is, Crawford down there. It seems innocent, one for two, but the one was a three-run homer and a sac fly to knock in all four runs for San Francisco. Up the middle and playing over there is Rosales. Or no, it's Brett Wallace in the shift. Rosales out in right field. Wallace from third base playing in the second base position to make the play. Two outs, Hunter Pence, pair of singles and three at bats. Sal Guerrero gets his first two men.
Yep.
He makes his major league debut, Tyron. Facing three pretty good hitters, Posey, Belt, and Pence. That's been thrown into the fire.
Is it really that cold? I mean, I love scarves, but
that'll chill in the air. Ground ball up the middle and through into center field. As we mentioned earlier, Ramirez is playing way over into the hole against Pence all night. And Hunter Pence has his third hit of the evening. And here's Crawford, first time up, two on. And he rips a high deep drive 423 feet into the right center field bleachers. And a 3-0 lead, and then follows with this sacrifice fly to get Posey home in the sixth inning. So four Giants runs, four RBIs for the shortstop Crawford.
And remember, that home run was a 3-0 count with the pitcher spot batting eighth tonight. That'd be Madison Bumgarner. So Crawford having the green light, 3-0, and sending out on the ball yard.
Guerrero is 25 from Colombia in South America. Line drive aimed for the right field corner, and that's going to bounce one hop against the boards. Running all the way is Pence. Here comes the relay. Here comes Pence. He scores 5-0. Into third goes Crawford. He's tagged out on the relay. But talk about a man with damage in his heart and his bat. Brandon Crawford comes to Petco tonight and knocks in all five Giants runs. Oh my. The head first dive under the tag of Brett Wallace. Did Wallace make the tag? Here's a second look.
Maybe gets him on the left shoulder. Kind of really tough to tell. Yeah. And the jury's back.
Rolled out. Crawford, nevertheless, with the RBI double, his fifth run batted in of the game. Padres coming up, bottom of the eighth, down by five.
Tony Gwynn, he's a player I always looked up to. I always admired the way he hit. And I've always kind of had an opposite field swing since I was a young kid. And you know, a lot of times people would tell me, man, your swing's, you know, I take this lightly, but just like Tony Gwynn's, you know, in that where I was able to hit the ball to left field and hit that six hole that Tony Gwynn, you know, made a living out of. And you know, once I came over here, I saw these stocks online and I had to snag them.
John Jay, and we'll have more on that as Brett Wallace finds that drive into the left center field alley. Had trouble fielding it cleanly for center fielder Denard Span, and Wallace winds up at second base with a double. He's two for two since coming off the bench.
I think it was last homestand or last road trip where Brett Wallace hit a ball. I think it was here at home, actually, before the last road trip. He hit a home run the opposite way, and then he hit an opposite field ball off the wall down by the left field foul pole. And then ever since then, realizing, you know what? I'll let that ball travel a little bit more and take it the opposite way. Plenty of hits out there as well, splitting the left center field gap for the double. Nicely done.
Two for two for Wallace. Trying to break the shutout bid of Madison Bumgarner. Travis Jankowski skies one into shallow left for the first out. A reminder, you saw that sneak peek of tonight's all-new SD Live featuring John Jay. And nice complimentary chat about his respect and admiration of the great Tony Gwynn. That's going to come up after Padres Live, after the game, Padres Live on Fox Sports San Diego, and then all-new SD Live. Well, Myers, line to center, a good play made by Span racing away. He struck out and doubled to left center. Up high, ball one. Bumgarner 4-2 on the season, 2.72 ERA, does not have a complete game. And Bruce Bochy has the bullpen busy.
Cody Guerin, the right-hander, heating up for the Giants.
...92 pitches now for Bumgarner. Now look at that ratio, 2-1 strikes. No walks allowed. Wallace's base hit, only the fourth by the Padres. Ground ball toward the hole. There's Crawford to close the gap and throw out Myers. Two away.
This copyrighted telecast is presented by Authority of the San Diego Padres. I may not be reproduced, retransmitted in any form, and the accounts and descriptions of this game may not be disseminated without the express written consent of the San Diego Padres.
So here's Derek Norris. He's grounded sharply to third and struck out the last two times. Bumgarner with 10 strikeouts tonight. Wallace with his lead at second. Strike one. Pinches the outside corner. So with a comfortable 5-0 lead, Bumgarner five outs away from his 90th career win at age 26. He just looks 36.
Yeah. Came up as a 20-year-old. Seems like he's been pitching forever. That's paint.
One and two.
Nissan Fox tracks right at the knees on the outside corner. Not much you can do with that pitch.
We got Norris the last time on that slow curveball. See if he feeds him one here. Popped up right side. Belt gives way to panic. And that's it for the Padres in the eighth inning. Bumgarner through eight innings, no runs, only four hits. It's 5-0 Giants.
Thing and MLB is back Saturday, starting with the D-backs taking on the Cardinals in a game you can only see on FS1. Then on Fox, it's the return of Baseball Night in America, featuring two of the best teams and rivalries in all of baseball as the Cubs battle the Giants. It's all Saturday on FS1 and Fox, or watch it live on Fox Sports. Go.
All right, Mark Grant, here we go, top of the ninth inning. And Tyrone Guerrera, his second inning of Major League pitching, will face Madison Bumgarner. He's got a bat. He's going to stay in the game here. Perhaps will try to complete the full nine innings and his first shutout of the season. Angel Pecan and then Denard Span to follow here in the top of the ninth. In case you're wondering, Brandon Crawford with all five runs batted in tonight for the Giants. That is not his career high. He knocked in six in a game against the Reds a year ago. But what a night. An RBI double, a sacrifice fly, and a big three-run homer that got the Giants on the board early, 3-0 back in the second inning. Bumgarner singled his last time, 1-for-3. It's his third hit of the season. He's hit another home run. Has 12 in his major league career. Four on the fastball that skips away. Man of the hour, Brandon Crawford. 5 runs knocked in. Way off the mark, 3-0. Time to check the Cholula flamethrower, fans.
Well, Tyrone Guerrero on the mound. All 6-8 of them. Let's see what he can get up to. 96. Ooh. That's hot sauce.
That is hot, isn't it?
Woo! Muy caliente. From Boca Chica, Colombia. Hey, let's face it. During his career, when he signed in 2010, walks have been the kryptonite for Guerrero.
Yeah, you average just, what, about 6 every 9 innings?
Yeah. So, and I'm just comparing. I'm not going to compare, obviously, Guerrero to a guy like a Randy Johnson, but when Randy Johnson first came up to the big leagues, he was having trouble finding the strike zone. He wasn't fully matured yet, getting used to his own body, all knees and elbows coming at you, until he honed it in, man. You know, he was all over the place, so it took him a while.
Well, you go back through the years, there are Hall of Fame pitchers that had the same trouble. How about Nolan Ryan?
Yes.
That's why the Mets let him go to the Angels. How about Sandy Koufax?
That's right.
He had trouble early in his career, so I'm not saying necessarily that Mr. Tyrone Guerrero is going to join that kind of company, but you know, even the best have to find their way into that strike zone and make quality pitches, purpose pitches. Bumgarner on a 4-pitch walk at first base. Myers keeping his distance. Pagan has walked and line to right, and a good play made by Myers on a tough short hop shot at first base the last time. That's a pretty good pitch there.
I think they were making nice down there at first base as Will Myers having a little chat with Madison Bumgarner.
Two products of the great state of North Carolina.
Yeah. Hey, let's just get along. What do you say there, kid? All right. It's all about love. I mean, you know, love is the answer. England Dan and John Ford Coley said that in a song.
High fly ball spinning Upton toward the line and left. One away. Pagan gone. Top of the order, Denard Spam.
Light of the world, shine on me. Love is the answer.
It is the answer.
Just wish more people would think that way. All the conflict would be just thrown out the window.
Yeah. Yeah, they're just, unfortunately, there's some bad dudes out there, huh?
Yeah, there are.
There's some people that would rather war than love. And people talk about profanity. I think that one word, W-A-R, that's profane. Some of the words we use, profanity, actually have pleasant right off the second base bag. Yeah. That's a pretty good piece of survey work by Span as he singles to center field. That moves Bumgarner to second. And with one out, Joe Panic comes up.
This ball goes right. Did that go between the legs of Guerrero and then off the bag? Hockey suit, return to sender.
He did that flamingo hop as if it hit him in the foot.
Yeah.
Let's see where that might have struck him. Ooh, off the instep. Panic. 0-for-4, but a couple of good plays defensively against him. One by Jankowski in center, another by Kemp and Wright.
Even the Beatles said all you need is love.
There you go. And if they, you know, when they crooned, you got to believe them, huh? Those lyrics. I think even Eleanor Rigby felt that, you know, all you need is love. Huh?
Good pull, Professor.
See, you know, I was born at night, but not last night. Yeah, love is a many splendored thing.
That's right.
Ground ball to third. Wallace to second. Back to first. Rosales not in time. Safe at first on the fielder's choice is Panic. 5-4 on the putout of Denard Span. Let's go back to the keys of the game brought to you by your San Diego Honda dealers.
I know, no crooked numbers for the Giants. Well, because they're one of the top teams that throws up crooked numbers in a ball game. 3 in the second. And jump on the fastball, avoid the strikeout. Madison Bumgarner, 10 strikeouts tonight. Let's get the red pen out, Professor. I'll take that F or what?
No. You can't take an F because if you just take one guy out of the Giants lineup, Crawford, we have a scoreless tie.
Right.
So you get a D.
Okay.
Duffy, 0 for 4, safe on an error by Ramirez at shortstop the last time. Bottom of the ninth inning, the Padres have Kemp, Upton, and Ramirez scheduled. And we'll see whether or not Bumgarner comes out to try to finish his own deal. 95 on the fastball, 2-0. You know, we're only 3 weeks away from that June draft where the Padres have a lot of outstanding. They have, what, 5 picks in the first 8 or so? And
restock, right?
3 in the first 26. That ball driven deep to right field. Kemp going into the narrow part of the yard and makes the catch. It would have been a fair ball. Good running play by Matt Kemp. And that'll do it for the Giants. In the top of the ninth, Kemp has been a busy outfielder tonight. 5-0, Giants. Well, it's been a two-man show tonight for the San Francisco Giants. Madison Bumgarner on the mound, allowing only 4 hits, a shutout through 8, and Brandon Crawford is shortstop, knocking in all 5 of the San Francisco runs. And Bumgarner will try to finish the job himself. His last time he shut out an opponent was last year against the Padres in September. He blanked the Padres.
And it would be his first shutout this year, his first complete game. 5-run pad.
Yeah, and Kemp, Upton, and Ramirez stand in the way. Kemp is 0 for 3. You know, back on the farm,
in Michigan, you had horses, and then you had what you call workhorses, the Percherons. Those big old, like the Budweiser.
Sure, the Clydesdales.
Those Clydesdales, right? But the Percheron, you know, they're just the big muscular equines. And if I had a pet Percheron, I'd call him Bumgarner or Mad Bum.
I'm surprised there's not a racehorse out there that somebody's jumped on and named him that.
Yeah. You could put a saddle on this guy, and he probably could take you at least three furlongs. He could plow the field for you. It's a good thing, you know, to plow the field.
Oh, yeah.
Got to till the soil.
That's right. Plant the seed, let it germinate. And what do you know, the seed was planted tonight, and Bumgarner trying to harvest a complete game.
Yeah, very nice. And then when you harvest, you have to use the combine. And then the combine is Brandon Crawford at short. That ball hit high to left field. High and deep. And Kemp will touch them all. There goes the shutout. Number 10 for Matt Kemp. And it's 5-1.
Well, nobody likes to get shut out. That's for sure. And Madison Bumgarner tries to bury one into Matt Kemp. And Matt Kemp gets a bead on this one and right on the sweet spot. And I think that went upper basket.
The third tier of the Western Metal Supply Company building.
Yep.
Yeah, that's off the L. That almost on the roof in left field.
That's a bomb.
Number 10 for Matt Kemp. He's in the top 10 in the National League in home runs with 10.
That's
and
a
he's
nice
in the top 10
swing.
In RBIs as well. Yeah. His 30th RBI. Make that 29. Sorry, Matt. 30's coming. So 5-1. Upton, ground ball to third. Duffy right there. The glove and throw him out. Well, it's time now for the Carl's Jr. stars of the game. Guess who? Now Bumgarner, even though he's now given up a run, 5-1 on 5 hits, 10 strikeouts, no walks. And Brandon Crawford knocking in all 5 Giants runs, a 3-run homer, a sack fly, and an RBI double.
Oh, it's still amazing to me after watching that home run off the bat of Crawford, how he got on top of that one enough to pull that ball to the beach, the San Diego Beach area. On that 3-0 pitch, it's amazing.
So here's a bit of confusion. That ball by Kemp hits so far that they measure it 412 feet. And here's the problem. The Western Supply Company building's a problem. As Crawford throws out Upton for the, or Ramirez for the second out. And that is that Crawford's ball lands, and then they measure where it lands, and it's, you know, 423 feet. But they're measuring Kemp's home run from where it hit the Western Metal Supply Company building, and it's still going.
Yeah.
And that might have been 450 feet. That was a major league home run, that's for certain. Just a dent in the pitching performance by Bumgarner, however, as he's down to the final out. It's Andy Rosales up 3 times, struck out swinging all 3 times. And there's a swing and a miss, strike one. Adam Rosales. Why I want to call him Andy. You know, I think his best friends do call him back in Chicago, Andy.
It's all good, Professor.
It sure is. And down to the final strike, the Padres.
Stay tuned for Padres Live, the postgame show. Going to hear from manager Andy Green, Mike Pomerantz, Mark Sweeney. Going to break it down what's happening here tonight and around the major leagues. Might even see that Matt Kemp home run again.
I hope so. Maybe they could replay it 6 times.
Sure.
Swing and a miss, strike 3, and that completes another brilliant performance on the mound. Madison Bumgarner
5-1, the Giants win it. Mike Pomerantz, what do you have in store for us?
Well, Dick, we're going to take a look at Madison Bumgarner and just decide with Mark Sweeney's help what made him so special tonight. And you're going to hear from Andy Green, plus a preview of SD Live with John Jay and the Giants' Brandon Crawford.